Hi everyone. This question comes from the 2001 senior competition, and only 4% of students got this one right. So we need to find the minimum value of that long algebraic expression, which I'm not going to read out. So pause the video here and see if you can figure it out. All right, so remember to like and subscribe if you haven't already. Now, onto my solution. So I'm going to go into quite a lot of detail about my thought process as I went through this question, because I think it's really obvious once you see the solution, but it's not obvious how to actually get there. So what I noticed was that this looks a lot like Pythagoras' theorem. Like if you imagine a right angle triangle with x there and 1, then that hypotenuse is square root x squared plus 1. So this might be helpful because if we can interpret that expression geometrically, then that might actually help us to work out the minimum value rather than having to resort to calculus or something, which is going to be really complicated for this question. Okay, so that's that one. For this one, it would look like, you know, you've got y minus x there, and then that's 2 squared, so 2 would be the other side. And then that length is that one. So I think my original thought with this was that maybe we'd like arrange all these triangles to make a quadrilateral. I don't know why I thought that or like how that would be useful, but that was kind of my initial idea. I think it's really important with these to just sort of like do something, even if you don't really have a clear idea of where you're going, because, you know, as you draw stuff and move things around, you might be able to figure it out. Like, you don't have to have a clear plan when you start out. So I think the next thing I did was I thought about like this y minus x and what that might mean. So if we've got a length y and we subtract a length x, then what we have left is the y minus x. So the next thing I did was to draw out, like, if that whole length is y, from there to there, and then we've got a small length x inside that, then this bit here will be y minus x. So we might draw it kind of like there's the x, there's the 1, and then that's that length. And then over here you'll have the y minus x and the 2 up there. So you know, and then there's, if we had like that whole length is z, and from there to there is y, then this bit will be z minus y, and so on. So I drew that up, and then that wasn't really helpful because what we want is to find the sum of all of these. So really what I want is for this one to start where this one ends, because then like the sum of these two will be sort of the distance traveling along there. So then what I did was I decided to shift this triangle up. So just shift this up to there. So let me just get rid of that. So instead of starting it on this line, let's put it there. So now we've got the 2 there. That distance is y minus x. And now this is the square root of y minus x squared plus 2 squared. Okay, so let's put on the z minus y. Let me just shift that to get some space. So for this one, we again want to start that out here so that we can add all these lengths together. Like, now this sum is going to be the distance as you travel along this thing. So that one was 1. Now, you can also think of these, instead of sort of like drawing out, you know, that whole thing as y and so on, we could think of it in terms of coordinates. So like that point's y, that one's x, that one's z, and then if we want 10 minus z, then that's going to be 10. So that's probably a better way of thinking of it. And like that point is 0. Okay, and then that's 3 squared. So for this one we want to have triangle with a height of 3, where that's 10 minus z. Okay, and then we want to find the minimum value of that total distance as you travel along here. So we can pick x, y, and z to be whatever we want in order to minimize that distance. But no matter what values of x, y, and z you choose, you're going to be traveling from here to there, and that point is always going to be at the same place because that's at 10, and that height is set by these heights. So the shortest distance from there to there is just going to be a straight line, like that. Now, it doesn't really matter what x, y, and z are. We weren't asked to find them, but you could find them if you wanted just by doing similar triangles. Like if you add up all these heights, we've got 1, 2, 1, and 3, so that total height is 7, and that distance is 10. So all these little triangles, if we actually move x so that that height still needs to be 1, x should really be there for it to stay on that straight line. And then, you know, if you wanted to work out what x was, you could just do similar triangles like that side to that side. So x to 1 has to be in the same ratio as 10 to 7. But it doesn't really matter because all that we want to work out is that minimum value of that, so the distance from there to there, which we can just do using Pythagoras. So square root of that side squared, 10 squared, plus that side squared, which is 7. So that makes root 149. And then we can't simplify that at all. So that is the answer to that question. So I had another look at the question and tried out doing it with calculus. And you know, it's actually not that bad. I knew from the start that they really didn't intend you to use calculus to do it because I don't think you need calculus for any of the questions in the Australian Mathematics Competition because they wouldn't want to disadvantage the students who haven't learned it yet. But okay, so what I did was I started out doing the partial derivative of that thing with respect to x. Now, I know most of the high school students won't have done partial derivatives. It just means that we sort of consider the y and the z to be constants and just differentiate this with respect to x, and it's just like this funny d notation. Okay, so I did that. You want to set that derivative to be 0 because that's what's going to minimize that whole thing. Yada, 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 lots of algebra. I got down to this point. Now, I knew from the start that we'd want each of these things to be positive. So I made that assumption there. The reason for that is that, like, we want all this to be as small as possible. And so we want, like, this to be small, and this to be small, and this to be small, and so on. Now, this is kind of like the distance between 10 and z. And this is like the distance between z and y and x and 0. So if you imagine on a number line, like, here's 0, and here's 10, and we want to place x, y, and z so that the distance from 0 to x is minimized and x to y is minimized and so on, then you'd want x, y, and z to be like lying between 0 and 10 in that order. Actually, the first thing I tried, even before I did, you know, the triangles and stuff, was that I thought, you know, maybe these would be equally spaced. So x would be 2.5, y would be 5, and z would be 7.5. So I was pretty comfortable making that assumption, and then that makes it a lot easier because then we only need to consider the plus there and not the minus. So that gives you y equals 3x, and then you do the derivative with respect to y as well and make a similar assumption, and you get the second equation, and then with respect to z and so on. And then you've got these three equations, and you can solve those simultaneously, and that gives you these values, and then you can plug those in and get to that. So it was obviously a lot more messy than the geometric solution, but you can do it with calculus. Oh, and I should explain why it's not the case that these are just equally spaced along here. So that's because all these numbers are different, and that effectively gives different weightings for the need for each of these intervals to be as small as possible. So it actually ends up with like x being quite low down there, and then there's y and z there. Just because that number is bigger, that makes it so that like
this interval, the 10 minus z, can be bigger, kind of. That doesn't need to make intuitive sense to you. It's just, that's why we have to do all the calculus, really.
All right, so leave me a comment below if you still have any questions, and give this video a thumbs up if you want me to make more like this. And stay tuned for the next one. I haven't picked out a question yet, but I'm sure it's going to be a fun one.